Hello friend, welcome back to our tutorial, Designing an Impressive Architectural Building in AutoCAD 2018 Metric. If you have been following along, go and open the file 00_039_DIABM where you save it. You can also download this file on the website. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the save as icon. This will bring the save drawing as dialog box. Rename this file to 00_040_DIABM. If you plan to see open this file in earlier version of AutoCAD, go to the file of type and change the file of type from AutoCAD 2018 and select that version. Click this down arrow. I'm going to select AutoCAD 2007. Click the save button to save the drawing in your new one. Go to the home tab, layer panel, and click the freeze layer button. Select this slab, and this slab, this roof, the veranda. Press enter. Now hold down your shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. Zoom in into this area. Go to the home tab. Click the down arrow after the drop panel and select the construction line command. Type H on your keyboard and press enter. Use the endpoint of the snap and snap to this point. Press enter to end the command. Press enter to repeat the construction line command again. Type V on your keyboard and press enter. Click on this area to draw this construction line. Press escape to get out of the command. Now go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the offset command. And specify offset distance from type 750. Press enter. Select this line and offset it out. Select this line and offset it in this direction. Press escape to get out of the command. Select this line, and hit delete on your keyboard. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the fillet command. At the select object prompt, select this line and this line. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the offset command. At the specify offset distance prompt, type 4800 millimeter. Press enter. Select this line and move. Copy it to this direction. Select this line and copy to this direction. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, draw panel, and click the down arrow. Select the construction line command. Type V on your keyboard and press enter. At the specifying through point prompt, use the endpoint object snap and snap to this vertex. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the offset command. At specify offset distance prompt, type 750 mm. Press enter. Select this line and offset it outside. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select this line and hit delete on your keyboard. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the fillet command. Type M on your keyboard and press enter. Select this line, fillet it to this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select this line, and this line. Right click into the drawing area, isolate object. Go to the view cube and click the top face of the view cube. Go to the home tab, draw panel, and select the line command. As specify first object prompt, click at the endpoint of this line. Now turn on the polar tracking. Move the mouse cursor and snap into this direction. Click. Press escape. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the fillet command. At the select first object prompt, click on this line and select this line. Now select this line. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the copy command. At specify base point prompt, use the mouse cursor and use the endpoint of this line. Now move and snap to the endpoint of this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Select these two lines. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the mirror command. At specify first mirror line prompt, click on this line and move the mouse cursor down and click. Press enter to end the command. Select this line and hit delete on your keyboard. Go to the home tab, modify panel, select the fillet command. Press M on your keyboard and press enter. Go to the home tab, draw panel, and select the line command. At the specifying first point prompt, click on this point and move to the right. Click. Press escape. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the fillet command. Type M on your keyboard and press enter. Select this line and fillet it to this line. Select this line and fillet it to this line. Select this line and fillet it to this line. Let's escape to get out of the command. Go to the view cube and click this vertex. Now type DI on your keyboard, press enter. I specify first point prompt. Click on this endpoint and move the mouse cursor and snap to this endpoint. Type F2, select this figure, hold down the control key and type letter C on your keyboard. Now go to the home tab, draw panel and select the line command. I specify first point prompt, click at the endpoint of this line. Now turn on the auto mode and move the mouse cursor into the Z direction. Right click and select the cal command. Backspace the zero, hold down the control key and type V on your keyboard to paste this figure. Now divide this figure by 2 and click the equal to sign. Multiply the results by 0.75, click the equal to sign, click apply. Move the mouse cursor at the positive Z direction and press enter. Press enter to end the command. Now select this line, hold down the control key and type 1 on your keyboard. This link the properties palette. As you can see, the line, the delta Z is 3600 and the length is 3600 millimeter. Close the property palette. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, modify panel and click the four layer button to bring your object. Hold down the shift key and zoom. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the line command. I specify first object point, use the endpoint object snap and snap to this vertex. Move the mouse cursor down to the negative Z axis and type 150 mm, press enter. Now move the mouse cursor outside, upload the cursor into this endpoint and snap at this point. Press escape to get out of the command. Select this line, right click, select similar, right click, isolate object. Select this short line and hit delete on your keyboard. Now go to the home tab, modify panel and select the fillet command. Type M on your keyboard and press enter. Select this line, fillet it to this line. Select this line and fillet it to this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Select this line, hit delete on your keyboard. Select this line, hit delete on your keyboard. Now select this line, go to the home tab, modify panel and select the copy command. As specified this point prompt, move the mouse cursor and click on this endpoint and snap to this endpoint. Let's escape to get out of the command. Select this line and go to the home tab, modify panel, select the copy command, snap at the endpoint of this line and copy it to this endpoint. Let's escape to get out of the command. Now go to the home tab, draw panel, click this down arrow and select the 3D polyline. As specified starting point of polyline prompt, click on this point, zoom in and click on this last point line. Now move the mouse cursor and click on this point, type C on your keyboard and press enter. Press enter to repeat the 3D polyline command. Start from this endpoint of this mid vertical line, this endpoint, click on this corner, type C on your keyboard to close the figure. Press enter to repeat the command again. Start the line from this endpoint and this endpoint, type C on your keyboard and press enter. Select the 3D polyline, this polyline, go to the 3D tools tab, surface panel and click the plan. Right click into the drawing area, isolate end object isolation, orbit around. Select this surface object, go to the home tab layer panel, click this down arrow and select the R3 to move the surface into the R3 layer. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab layer panel and select the isolate command. At the select object prompt, select this vertical line or any object on the garbage layer and press enter. Now select the profile and hit delete on your keyboard. Go to the home tab layer panel, click this down arrow and click the previous command. Go to the view control, click the custom view and select SE isometric. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the save button to save your model. So I'm going to stop this video at this point. In the next video, I will continue to model our roof. If you find this tutorial useful, please click the like button and share it to your friends. If you have any question or you want a specific tutorial, please leave a comment below. If you want to continue on this tutorial or any other tutorial on my channel, please subscribe. Thanks very much for watching. I hope to see you in the next class. Goodbye.